drum replacement. So this is a new feature in Logic 9, which is pretty awesome. And what I've been doing so far is just kind of getting all the drums ready. We've talked about quantization, we've talked about time aligning things, talked about grouping them, and now, because I get to this point, I'm still like, well, these drums are okay. You know, they're not the best drum kit. They're not recorded as well as they could be. So I really want a different sound. I'm going to select a track, starting with a snare drum. The main thing is to select the header for it, because even though it's in a group, I just need to select the header. We go to track and say drum replacement doubling. So with this, we can either completely replace the sound of it or just add an additional one in there. So we have this dialog here. It says, which instrument are we going to be replacing? In this case, snare. And do we want to do replacement or do we want to double it? For the moment, I want to double it, because with doubling, it's going to allow me to really see exactly what's happening here. And then I can mute it, the other one, if I need to later. Then we have a threshold. And this threshold allows us to go through and make sure that all the hits that are snare hits are highlighted here. So basically every hit there, and you have to adjust that depending on the material you're working with, just so you don't have too many. So if I go down too far, you'll start seeing some of these random ones come in. Those are not actual snare hits. And if I go too high, we're going to lose some of them. So just have to adjust that and then do a quick check on it to make sure that we've got everything. We can pre-listen if we want to hear what's going on. We can have it trigger a specific note. In this case, I set it to auto because I'm going to be choosing my snares from a different place. And if we need to do a timing offset, we can. So I'm not going to worry about this. For the most part, these only have to be used in specific cases. And that's if you want to change overall timing of the kit. So one reason you might want to do this is for the reason we were going through the timing correlation in the previous tutorial. Also, if you're going to be using a snare that has a little bit more of an attack time in, so it ramps in, you may want to offset for that. So in that case, you may do like a negative offset to have it come in a little earlier. So that's one potential use. For the most part, I don't use this. We can also set the average attack time, which is based on all this information here. But again, I'm going to leave this at zero. Okay, let's push OK. What happens is it adds a new track with MIDI data inside. And you can actually see the MIDI data by opening the piano roll. It's actually taking velocity data, so how hard it was hit, and it's taking timing data for all the notes that were triggered there. Pretty awesome, because now what we can do, and let's actually take off these other tracks for a moment. Solo this one and solo this one. Go through and pick whatever snare you want from Logic's library of sounds, and then it can be blend in. Now, if you were to do replacement instead, this track would actually be muted and disabled, but as it is, it's still there. So I can actually now go, if I want to, and mute this particular region. They're all grouped together, so we'd have to remove this one from the group, and then we can mute it. One thing you want to do here is probably control some of the dynamics of this. And one thing you can do to do that, well, once we get into MIDI, we'll talk a lot more about this, but I'm going to go over here to this area where it says dynamics, and I can actually pick a fixed dynamic, or I can say I want you to do 75% of all dynamics, or I want you to do more and push it all up. So then these will all be louder. And then we got a lot beefier sound. We can do this with a kick, we can do it with toms, we can do it with any number of other instruments, and it's a really powerful way to get any kind of drum sound you want based on the performance that you got in the original session. And in this case, it's actually a quantized version of the original performance, so it's going to fit with the song, but it's definitely come a long way since then. Okay, let's move on to audio to score.